Welcome. Today we are going to introduce a new Roman road seen from the sky. I'm going to talk about a road that connected that Roman port city in the Bay of Biscay, the ancient Flaviobriga, with another smaller city in the inland called VXAMA BARCA, the current Osma in the north of Alava. This Roman road also communicated all the current territories of the north of Burgos, what is known as the origin of Castilla, the county of Mena Valley, Montija, Medina de Pomar, Losa Valley, and ended up in the Berberana area, more or less. This Roman road not only presents vestiges seen from the sky, as we are going to see many of them, but also on land, which I want to show you because it is likely that it will encourage you to visit the area. Like the ones you are seeing in the county of Montija, these embankments that still have the curves in place and that can really make you understand very well what a Roman road is like. It still has a powerful surface structure, as you can see a natural clay soil through which it would be impossible to drive on if it were not for this powerful structure, and further on, in the county of Medina de Pomar, in the town of Salinas de Rocío, where there is a site, a good Roman city, here you can see this very powerful structure also with its tiny grains on the surface used for the traffic. And now let's move on to the county of Losa Valley, where you can see how, behind the town called the Road, that is, a town through which the roadway passed, which is why it's called that way, because the Roman road reached there. Unfortunately, even though it is also called the entire land and all the areas it runs through as the road, in the end, it was partially destroyed over an enormous length due to the land consolidation. Well, at that time nobody knew the consequences. This comes from the early 80s, approximately, when the land consolidation took place. As you can see, the trail is very evident in some areas. In others, we will see later, they have an impressive, enormous length, which can only be seen accurately from the video. I believe that back in the 80s, when the land was consolidated and a large part of the so-called the road was plowed, the technicians involved in the land consolidation, they had no clue what a Roman road was like. There were also no reports, no one had frankly seen it, not even the local people. Since we are addressing very recent times in the 80s, it is likely that some archaeologists would surely have been interested in knowing if there was something out there. But due to lack of knowledge back then, it was practically impossible to identify a Roman road and its main traits. I wish to reiterate my complaint about the erroneous way that universities persistently teach the Roman road engineering. This ultimately leads to its destruction because ignorance hinders people from identifying the roads. It is probably the biggest factor of destruction. It is noticeable a few short sections that are still well preserved, like the one we just saw from above, which remains obstructed because it is situated among the farms that have been parcelled out, but preserves its embankment and a very powerful pavement structure, as you can see in this case, on the natural rock substrate, with its well-defined pavement, its very clear foundation curves, here you see it, and a very significant thickness despite being on natural rock. This is the stretch that I'm mentioning, fossilized between destroyed stretches, where you can see the tracks of the last structures that were around, along with carriages, because it hasn't been used for years. It doesn't have a clear direction, as you can see. Up ahead, there you can see two towns on the horizon, Villaventín on the left and Castresana on the right. The farmlands situated near these two towns, over the green areas, there is a very long plowed Roman road, as you are about to see now. It is so enormous, I had photographs from 2009 and early 2010, because I discovered all the embankments of this Roman road that you have seen and you are about to see. I discovered it at the end of November 2009, that is to say, at a very recent period, and there were no prior reports. I managed to find out one after the other, tracking them down throughout this region, in this area north of Burgos. As you can see, when we later flew over the area with a light aircraft, the result was impressive, but the photographs did not really do any justice. It is this type of continuous flight recordings that last even longer than desired for the viewer. Because you see almost the same thing, but you can get an idea of the magnitude and length of the structure and how easy it would have been to leave a small preserved strip, which has no arable value. In this way, they could have preserved a fantastic heritage of this road that has a tremendous structure. Fortunately, there, at the end in the area of Via Ventina and Castresana, along that boundary you see, the Roman road goes back up to that rocky hill that has been preserved for kilometers. The embankments are there, and I invite you to go and see them. Those of you who can, you can find the maps on the web, www.viasromanas.net. They will allow you to reach this spot and personally witness what a Roman road looks like on the ground. We can see here the same as we saw before in the county of Montija. The embankments are tremendous. It is evident that they rise above the ground, 1 meter high, for kilometers, as you can see here, but you should imagine a perfect trapezoid 6 meters above the ground, where two carriages crossed. This is a 2,000-year-old fossil that no one has cared for, that's why it remains like this. I invite you again to see them for yourselves. That's all, have a nice day!